Now, recently news came out of a pizza place in Indiana that came out as anti-gay. I said that we weren't going to serve gay people or serve pizza at any sort of gay function, gay wedding, what have you. And by the way, I'm pretty much the only asshole that would ever have pizza at my wedding because I'm just that way. Well, after that came out, and of course after they got slammed by the media, conservatives decided that they would slam back. Their target, however, is the reporter that actually reported this story to begin with. Now, this reporter's name is Alyssa Marino. And what she had done is she had stopped by Memories Pizza while seeking a business owner's reaction to this law signed by Governor Mike Pence. Now, she stopped by Memories Pizza, and the pizza owner, Crystal O'Connor, decided, yeah, I'm going to talk to her, and I'm going to be honest. I'm going to say that if a gay couple came in and wanted us to provide pizzas for their wedding, we would have to say no. That's what she told the reporter. Now, like I said, conservatives got super pissed and started targeting this reporter. Now, I've got a series of tweets that I want to get to from different conservatives, but first, there was conservative websites that basically started this backlash against her. Now, the National Review Online accused Marino of unfairly thrusting the pizzeria into the public eye. By doing what? By asking a question and actually airing an honest response. Okay. Scott Ott of PJ Media said, quote, if I were forced to mark out a storyline, it would be this. A nice lady in a small town tries to be helpful and polite to a lovely young reporter from, quote, the big city. Basically saying that this was an ambush. Oh, this is ambush reporting. It's gotcha questions. Trying to make her look bad. Dude, I think the only person that made her look bad was her. But continuing with conservative media. The Daily Caller said Marino, quote, ruined the business and destroyed a family's safety. Once again, how? By airing the actual thoughts of this business owner? Okay. Well, after all this, of course, conservatives on Twitter decided to take it a few steps farther. There's a tweet. Storyteller destroys Christian-owned pizza business. Proud of yourself, sweetie? Tweets in Heflings Harrison. Brent Martini tweets in, nice reporting on the pizza people. You'll get yours, girlfriend. What goes around comes around. Oh, boy. Joseph Krynock on Twitter tweets in, Memories Pizza is a non-story. Should have left it at that. Do not destroy businesses. Once again, she was getting reaction from a business owner on what the law is about, since part of this law now extends the religious right, you know, the rights to religious freedom, to a business. That's what's different between the RFRA law in Indiana and the RFRA law federally and in the other 19 states that have similar laws. This is much more expansive. It expands the business. It only makes sense that a journalist asked questions of a business owner, someone who was affected by the law. And she gave her honest opinion, which proved to be very unpopular. An American veteran tweets in, just walked in my ass. Interesting phrase. I don't know what he meant by that. But he continues, can it, lady? If something happens to these people, blood is on your hands. Okay, so let me address something quickly. Okay, real quick here. I'm against threats. Whether it comes from people who are supporting gay marriage and are against the business, or those who are defending the business. Threats should not come from either side. I will denounce and reject threats from either side, whether or not I agree with you or not. Giving personal threats, not a good thing. I would advise against it. Doing threats makes both of your sides look bad. Don't do it. Don't be dumb. You can boycott, and I definitely support that. You know, the thing that'll hurt them the most is their money. You hit them in the pocketbook, leave a bad review, that's fine. But when it crosses the line into personal threats, that's where it crosses the line, essentially. So, don't threaten people. Another Zion tweets in. Slander and libel are crimes. Encouraging some Memories Pizza to file charges against you both. Okay, hold on here. Slander and libel. Quoting somebody verbatim and asking them a question and getting their honest thoughts does not equal slander or libel. Quoting somebody verbatim is not a crime. Continue. Guy Fleegman tweets in, must feel so proud this evening. Here's hoping karma catches up with you soon. Another tweet. You found a naive and offensive hardworking family and destroyed them for entertainment. You are vile. Another tweet. This story was amateurish at best and criminal at worst. I suspect the latter. I'm assuming you meant latter, but I get your point. How is it criminal? I don't know. Someone else is pretty direct. You should be fired. For doing journalism. Yeah, okay. All right. Now, some of these tweets continue to get worse. Except for this one. This one's not too bad. We couldn't expect like responsible journalism, could we? Well, as they say, karma sucks. I don't see the problem with the journalism asking a question and getting an honest answer. All right. Brew Citriot seems to think that this is a gotcha question. ABC News used a troll question about catering weddings to troll PC fascists into attacking Memories Pizza. Gays are the new ISIS. But this one's probably the worst one. Coming from Jacob1758 MP. Alyssa Marino is a, quote, is a gay/lesbian terrorist. Just makes me hate gays even more. I shall not yield. Hashtag I hate gays. Well, if you weren't clear, this guy seems to have a problem with gay people. This is your classic homophobe. Now, what do these tweets teach me? Well, reading some of this stuff from conservative media, from conservative tweets, just shows me that conservatives are some of the biggest whiners that you could ever talk to. They're the biggest. They play the victim card so well, and it's so much projection. Oh, I'm the victim. Stop victimizing me by actually broadcasting what I really think to people. Stop telling other people my super unpopular opinion. You can't even do that. You can't even tell someone what someone else actually says without them getting incredibly pissed off about it and to have them whine and cry like little bitches. That's right. You're little bitches. Stop whining. Equality is the law of the land. You're just going to have to get used to gays wanting equal rights.